the Thimblehooks. Thanks for stopping by. Did you miss me? Oh, it's been so hot this summer that I took some time to just design instead of sitting in the studio covered with really bright spotlights. That is just no fun when it's 115 degrees outside. But today's project is the giant bag that is inspired by that awesome Raffia Prada bag that you've seen all over the place. This is today's project. We get to make the big one. So we've already made the little one, which is right here. But I had so many people ask me for, I want that big bag, that big market tote. It's like, well, let me work on that. So that's kind of what I've been doing, one of the many things. And we have the awesome hat, of course. I'll set those aside for right now. This one is a raffia in the pink. And of course, I always make things in pink. And then this was my prototype, really obnoxious pink. I love it. But we're going to make this one today in white cotton. This one was made with Red Heart Super Saver. This one is made with raffia. That I got off of Amazon because it's not as easy to find. And today we're going to work with peaches and cream cotton. These are 120 yards each. You'll want 5. You're going to have some left over, but it's just going to be not quite enough if you use 4. So get 5. These are like less than $2 at Walmart. You will want a 5mm hook and a 3.5mm hook and a 3. At different points in time, we're going to change out our hooks. We're going to start with the 5. So grab your 5 and get a couple of stitch markers ready. This worked from the bottom up, so we're going to start right here. Slip knot and chain 32 with our 5mm hook. Three, four, 31, and 32. So we just have a little chain of 32. And now we're going to work around this, kind of like when you're making an oval or the sole of a baby booty or any of those kind of things. So we're going to start with the very closest chain that you can actually work into. We're not going to do our back bumps this time. We're just going to work into this chain through one loop and single crochet all the way down. Single crochet 30. I'm going to chain 32 and now we're going to single crochet 30. And I'll meet you down at this end when I get my 30 in. It's 29 and 30. And we should have one chain left, which I do. In this last chain, we are going to put in 3 single crochets in this last chain. 1, 2, and 3. Now we are going to turn our chain so our stitches that we just made are kind of facing down now. And this is the other side of our chain that we just made. Our chain of 32 is on the top. We're going to work down the other side of that chain. So move over to this next spot. So there's where we just did our chain 3. Down this side we will single crochet 30 again. Just like that. 1. Down the other side of the chain, 2, right in there, 3, right in here, 4, and do 30 of those and I'll meet you in a second. And there's 29, and our last one is right here, and there's 30. And now also in that same spot that we just did our 30th single crochet, we are going to add 3 more. 3 more single crochets, so that technically that last stitch has 4. And I'm going to mark this last stitch. So there's round 1. Super easy peasy. And this is the very, very bottom of our bag. Now round 2, we're going to go into our very first spot here. It's our very first stitch from last time, and slip stitch, chain 1, so we can start working on row 2. Round 2. So in that same spot that we just did our little slip stitch into, we are going to single crochet into that spot, and then we're going to mark our stitch. So that was single crochet number one, we want to do 30. So there's 2, 3, 4, and there's number 29, and 30. And now we're to our corner where we had put in our 3 and made a kind of a turn the corner there. We're going to make an increase now. So in each one of these 3, 1, 2, 3, the next 3, we want 2 single crochets in each of those previous round stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4. Five and six. So we're doing a little bit of an increase. We're right in here where you can see this kind of goes at an angle and gets bigger. That's how we're going to do it. Now we did our increase on that little side right there, and now down this side, 30 more single crochets. Let's do 30. 1, 2, 29 and 30. So we went down the other side now, working in around, and we have 1, 2, 3 stitches left, which is perfect. Just like we did on this side, we want to do our increase, so 2 single crochets in each of these last 3 stitches. So there's 1 and 2, 3 and 4, and 5, and 6. Now I'm going to move my marker to that last stitch, because stitch markers are my friend. Just easier. I don't want to count all these in case I get one off. I don't want to count my stitches. Nobody wants to count all their stitches in the round. So that was round 2. Super easy. So right now we want to go into our first stitch that's marked here in my orange stitch marker, and we want to do a slip stitch and a chain 1 so we can work round 3. So round 3 is really easy. No increase on round 3. We are just going to do single crochets all the way around. It'll be a total of 72. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's a single crochet all the way around till you get to this marker. And there's my last 2 stitches in round 3. Boom and boom. Now I'm going to move my stitch marker to my last stitch so I know exactly where the start and the end is, and there's round 3. Round 4 is exactly the same thing. So we're going to slip stitch into our first mark stitch, chain 1, and single crochet all the way around one more time. No increase in round 4, just 72 single crochets all the way around. And I'll meet you back at my blue marker in just a moment. And my last 2 stitches back to my blue marker. And there's round 4. Voila. So we're just making a little boat, little bathtub. This is the bottom. We're working in the round the whole time, all the way up this bag. And all of this will be worked at the same time. It's really fun. This one, I really like how this one turned out. So I'm going to move my marker over to this last stitch that I did. So that was round 4. There's our round 4 of our bottom. Round 5 is an increase round. So we're going to go into our first mark stitch, slip stitch, chain 1, and our increase round this time is, we're going to start with 30 single crochets just like we did on the other rows, or the other rounds. There's my new marker. And we're going to do 30. That was number 1. So single crochet 30, and I'll meet you in a moment. And there's 29 and 30. Now we get to do the increase on the corner again. we just went going straight along the edge. And then when we get to the corner here, we want to do an increase. And this one is a sequence of single crochet. And then the next one will be two singles. We'll do that three times. So the next one is a single crochet. And the next one after that is an increase with two single crochets in the same stitch. And one more time, single crochet. And then two in the next stitch. So there's our increase again. So we just made it around our corner. So after we make it around our corner, you probably can guess, because I try to make these as simple as possible, we are going to single crochet 30 again down to the other end. And my last two stitches, there's 29 and there's number 30. So we work down that side again, and one more increase. Just like we did on this side, we're going to increase over here. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stitches left. Yay! Single crochet in the first one, and then two in the next. For our increase, single crochet, two in the next, single crochet, and two in this last one that's marked in blue. And there you go. There is round 5. So we're going to move our stitch marker and do our slip stitch like we've done all the other previous times, and chain one, so we're ready to do rounds 6 and 7. All right, we just finished round 5, which is an increase round. Round 6 and 7 are just single crochet all the way around. That will be a total of, we have just increased up to 78. So we are going to single crochet all the way around for round 6 and round 7. I'll meet you when I'm done with round 7. And here's my very last stitch in round 7. And I'm going to move my marker. So now it's starting to look a lot more like a boat. This is the bottom of our bag. And slip stitch. And chain one, so we can do round 8, which is another increase round. So like we did with all the other ones, we're going to start again in that same stitch that we slip stitched in with single crochet. That was number 1. And we want to do 30 of them again. So 30 all the way down. All right, here we are, 29 and 30. And they were going to increase around this corner like we did before. This is our last increase round. So we're going to do 2 single crochets and then an increase. So there's 1, 2, and an increase is 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to do that sequence 3 times. So there's a single crochet, and then 2 singles in the same stitch. And do that one more time. Single crochet, and then 2 in the same stitch. So we did another increase around our corner. And I bet you guessed it. We want a single crochet 30 down the other side. So let's do our 30 until we get to our other corner. And there's 29 and number 30. So we're at our other corner. So we want to do an increase again, the same way we did on the other side, which is 2 single crochets and an increase. There's 1, 2, and then an increase is 2 in the same stitch. We want to repeat that. Single crochet, 2 singles in the same stitch. And then our last 3 stitches, yay! Our counts are all right. 1 single crochet, 2 single crochets, and in our blue marked stitch here, we want to put in 2 singles, 4, and increase. and move my stitch marker. So there's our little boat. It's getting a little bit bigger. We're almost done. That was round 8. We're going to slip stitch, chain 1, so we're ready to do rounds 9 and 10. And rounds 9 and 10 are just single crochets all the way around, and now we're at a total of 84. 84 stitches all the way around. So 2 rounds of single crochets all the way around. So this is round 9, and you'll do the exact same thing for round 10. And I'll meet you when I am done with my round 10. And my last stitch for my round 10. Right there. Yay! And I'll move my marker like I have been. So there, we're done with this solid bottom right here. Now it gets a little bit more interesting and it works pretty fast. So we're going to do our slip stitch into our first mark stitch so that round can be called complete. This one might be a little bit easier to see than the raffia. So we're going to start working on our mesh parts right up here. So our next round, which is round 11, we're going to change out our 5mm hook, put that one away, and we're going to get out our 3.5. My tulip. I love my tulips. They're so nice. This is a perfect project for these. I love exactly how they're working with this cotton. Wonderful. Alright, our next round, we're going to start on our mesh. The first round is different than all the other ones, but not crazy different. So we're going to chain 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I know I never do this, but this time it's important. This counts as a double crochet and a chain 1. You know, I don't like to do them that way, but it looks best with this bag. So I just have to deal with it. And now we're going to double crochet into the very next, not the mark stitch, because that one's already taken care of, with this counting as a double crochet. So over to the next stitch, double crochet. And chain 1. Into the next one, double crochet. And a chain 1. Double crochet, chain 1. So we want to do that all the way around. Double crochet, and a chain 1 in between. All the way around. I'll meet you back at my blue marker in just a moment. There's my last couple stitches in round 11. So again, double crochet, chain 1. And there's my last one in my blue stitch marker. And don't forget, in that last one, you still need to do your chain 1. We can get rid of him now. 1, 2, 3. In this stitch right here, we want to work a slip stitch, but we want to go underneath both of these loops, just like this. Very important. And slip stitch. That is the easiest way to make this look seamless. Because, you know, I don't like seams. I don't like knots that show. I don't like any of those things. And you can see by adding that chain in between everything, we just did another increase. It's way bigger. Now we're right in here. And you can see how this is going at an angle here and getting bigger. So now round 12 is basically the same thing. I'm going to do chain 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, because that counts as a double crochet and the chain 1. And in the top of this double crochet, the next double crochet stitch, let's do a double crochet there too. And a chain 1. And do the same thing again. Double crochet and a chain 1. I can take this marker out now. It's pretty obvious where our starting point and our stopping point will be, so we don't need to have any markers around right now. And do that again. Double crochet in the top of the next stitch, chain 1 all the way around. And I'll meet you right back over here in just a minute. There's my last 2 stitches, double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Make sure you do your chain one. So we still need to be able to connect this with our nice space. And again, slip stitch into the third stitch up, one, two, three, and go under both of these front loops with a slip stitch. This is round 12. So we had 10 on the bottom, 11, and here's round 12. Now rounds 13 through 19, so 7 more rounds, are exactly like round 12. So we're going to chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, which counts as a double crochet and a chain 1. And then we're always working into the top of the stitches, never into the space. Always into the top of these stitches for 7 more rounds, just like what we had done in round 12. And I will catch up with you as soon as I get done with round 19. Okay, and here's my last double crochet, chain one, and then slip stitch into our third stitch up, one, two, three, under those two front loops. Here's our slip stitch. There. So there's a total after we do our bottom. There's a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. So a total of 9 mesh ones here, all the way up. Now I get to start the really fun part, which is our little triangle. And this was trial and error for a little while, just because I needed to work the mesh and the triangle at the same time. The mesh and the triangle used different stitches. This is a double crochet, this is a single crochet, and it's too high. So it was a little bit tricky, but I figured it out. And now I'm going to share it with you so it can be easy. Fasten off the white one that we're working with, because we need to move around to the other side. Snip and just tighten that up. It doesn't show very much, but there is still a little bit of a seam right here. Make sure you get this all flattened out the way that you want it to be. Exactly where you want it to look, nice and flat. And then flip it over. Keep this in the back. Flip it over. And I already marked my stitch here. You want to find the center. Our triangle will be right here in the center. So just count where you find the center. Right here is where we're going to work. And now we're going to alternate back and forth between your 3 and your 3.5. The 3 is for the triangle. The 3.5 is for your mesh. If you don't have a 3, you can keep going with your 3.5. That'll work just fine. I promise. Right, now you're going to need another ball of yarn, because you're going to have 2 working pieces. You're going to be making the triangle with 1 ball of yarn, and the mesh with a separate ball of yarn. Because it was kind of tricky, so I had to figure out how to do. These are double crochet mesh, and this is single crochet, and each row has 2 rows of single crochet for 1 row of this, of my mesh. So, that was a little tricky. So I finally figured it out, and I'm going to show you as easily as I possibly can how to do both of these at the same time. So we're not going to build our triangle and then work around it. We're going to work them both at the same time. So we're going to take our new skein of yarn, and we're going to start right in here in the center part. Now would be the time that you would use your 3mm hook, because you're going to use that for this only. So we want to fasten on our yarn right here. And I'm just going to flip this guy over. Fastened on. And I'm going to do 3 single crochets in this chain space, in the mesh loop. There's a 1, 2, and 3. And now what I just said before, there's 2 rows of single crochet for every row of our double crocheted mesh. So now I want to chain 1, turn my work, and single crochet back. 1, 2, and 3. I just want to pull up a loop, turn back again. I'm going to pull up a loop and set that aside until it's time to work more of the triangle in the middle. So I can set my 3 millimeter down. So now I'm going to take my working yarn for the mesh part and fasten on here where I have it marked in red at the next double crochet over. Fasten on my yarn and chain 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That counts as a double crochet and your chain 1. So we're going to do a double crochet here. Double crochet, chain 1, always working into the top of the stitch, not the mesh square chain space. Double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, and chain 1, and just move over here a little bit. So we can see what we're doing. Right here we're working with this ball of yarn. I'm working the middle triangle piece, and with the other working yarn I'm doing the mesh, and we will hook up over here. Most important part is to make sure that your working yarn for your triangle for this logo in the center is off to the right. So when we get all the way around, we can hook those up. We can work everything together. So now what I want to do is work our mesh all the way around till I come back to here, and I will meet you there in just a second, and we will do the next row of our logo. Okay, I'm almost back with my mesh meeting my logo. Chain 1. To do one more last double crochet right here, because now we're going to finish this little mesh square. So we're going to chain 2. This is the only time we're going to do 2 chains, is when we're working up to our logo. So toss this back a little bit, and now we get to pick up the loop from our other skein right here. And just reminding me, because my pink one is right here, now would be the time to change this loop or change your hook out to your 3. If you're not changing, that's perfectly fine. You can just use the 3.5 the whole time. So now I have both loops on my hook from both yarns. My working yarn that I'm going to be using right now is from my mesh. And here's the other one. So they're both on my loop. Or both loops around my hook. Now I want to go through this first stitch right here, right in here, and work over the non-working yarn right now, and do a single crochet through everything. Just pull that nice and tight, and do a single crochet through both of those loops. Boom. And now single crochet, working over that other yarn. One. And do that all the way across. And all the way across right now is only 3. So there. So now we finished that first little square. And we closed up this little loop right here. Now we want to take a little tug on the yarn that we carried along, just to make sure that it doesn't have a big loop over here, and it's nice and tight to keep our squares being squares. There you go. So there's our first little square. Hooray. Now we can put the pink one down, because that was just for that square. I'm going to do 2 chains and work around this yarn as much as you can to carry it along just a little bit further. I'm going to go like this. There's a chain, and do that again. Just want to bring it with a little bit. In this third chain, we want to go into both, under both loops, because it makes it look finished the best, since this is the front of the bag. And I want to take this yarn, this ball of yarn that is being used for our logo or for our triangle and just pull it through. Take it off your hook, make a big loop, and just kind of set it off to the side. So we're going to need that to go this direction in just a second. Now we want to go back into that same stitch, that same chain, third chain, and slip stitch with our working yarn for our mesh. Slip stitch into the chain space, and then slip stitch into our next stitch, and chain four. 1, 2, 3, 4. That again counts as our double crochet and a chain one. So then let's go over and do a double crochet, chain one, working some mesh just to get this working yarn out of the way. Off to the side a little bit. I just work like four or five of them so I don't get my yarns confused. I'll just pull up that yarn and kind of push it off to the side a little bit. So there's the start of our next one. So we're going to go back to this yarn again and the pink hook. Flip our work. We want to work the other direction, remember. Always want to get our working yarn back over to where we're going to meet up with it. So here's a chain one, and then we want two single crochets in this chain space. So we're going to increase by two on this side. Three single crochets, just single crochet all the way across. In this instance, it's three. This is our first square. 1, 2, and 3. And then two more single crochets in this chain space. So we have increased this to 7 right here. So this is 3 and this row is 7. So we just did our first pass on that one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now we just pull this up, turn it back the way it was, and we'll kind of ignore this yarn and the pink and the 3 millimeter. For a minute. Alright, now this working yarn is back over to the right. It's waiting for my mesh, so now I have to mesh all the way around. I can finish this round. So we'll do our double crochets with the chain one in between all the way around, and I will be over to our logo part, our triangle, in just a second. Alright, here we go, and I'm almost back with my mesh. All the way around, double crochet, chain one, and we need to do one more. Double crochet, because now we're going to be able to connect and make this little mesh square right above this one, right here. So this is where we chain two. Remember, we're going to chain two right before we get here, just to make sure our square actually is a square. Otherwise it gets a little bit too tight. So we're going to toss this back just a second. Grab that other loop, get it on your hook. Change out to your 3 millimeter if that's what you are doing. If you're not going to do that, just continue on with your 3.5. Now we want to tighten these up so we have both yarns are on our hook right now. Go into our first space right here. And over the logo yarn. Pull everything a little bit tight. So we're going to do a single crochet through both of those yarns. Just like that. And then single crochet all the way across. There should be 7. There's number 2, number 3, and carry your yarn in the back. Number 4, 5, 6, and 7. We want to take a little tug at our logo yarn and just make sure that it's nice and tight. Not overly tight, but we don't want it to be too loose at all. So just like that, stays nice and square. Your mesh square will stay a square. Go back to our 3.5 millimeter hook. And there's our working yarn. For our mesh, here's the working yarn for our logo. We want to chain two with the mesh yarn, kind of working around the other one just to carry it along a bit. So it's kind of in there. And now in our third chain, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to go under both loops and grab our logo yarn, our triangle yarn, and pull it through. Pull up a loop and toss it off to the side because we'll work this direction in just a moment. But first, we're going to finish this. We're going to go into that same chain with our mesh working yarn and pull through a slip stitch and then slip stitch into the chain mesh space and then slip stitch into the double crochet and then chain 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Also counting as a double crochet and a chain 1, and then we'll just work this over a couple just to move it off to the side a little bit. Our normal mesh, double crochet with the chain 1 in between, working in the top of stitches, not in the chain space here. There, we'll just move that over a little bit. All right, now our mesh, we're not going to work that for just a second, so grab the 3mm hook again, and we're going to work the other direction for our second pass of the next part of our logo. So we just want to get our loop back on our hook for our triangles yarn, our triangle skein, to a slip stitch, and then in this chain space we want 2 single crochets, 1 and 2, adding 2 on this side. Now we want a single crochet all the way across, which in this row would be 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So in this chain space we want to add 2 more. So we just went from 7 to 11. So we went 3, this was 7, and now we're going to be working 11. We increase 2 on each side each time, which is technically an increase of 4. So flip that back over again, pull up that loop, and now it's off to the right hand side, hanging out waiting for our mesh to come back. So I'm going to do one more round, all my mesh all the way around here, which is double crochet and a chain 1 all the way around until we're back to our triangle logo. And I'm almost back to my logo, or my big triangle. So here we go, double crochet, chain 1, and we'll need 1 more, right like this, double crochet, but then we're going to make this one as always a chain 2 when we're hooking up, getting everything connected with our mesh and our logo connected. I want to chain 2 right here to make sure that this square actually stays being a square and it isn't too tight. So we want to grab this loop again, put the working yarn behind, grab this loop so they're both on the hook, tighten it up a little bit. Now we want to work a single crochet into our very first single crochet right there and work over and bury that other yarn, single crochet. So we're going to work through all those loops. So now they're all connected. Now single crochet, burying that other yarn all the way across. 9, 10, and 11. Give this our triangle yarn a little tug to make sure that it's tight and keeps our triangle square on this edge. Give that just a little tug. Make sure it looks good. Now our square is a square. Go back to our working yarn. We want to slip stitch or chain two around that other yarn real quick, just to carry it along with us. In our third chain, there's our chain four that we have in the third chain up. Go under both of these front loops. Pull through the triangles yarn. Just pull through a loop and set it off to the right a little bit so that we can work this direction again. Now in that same chain three, work in there a slip stitch from our mesh yarn, a slip stitch in this chain space, and a slip stitch in the next double crochet, and chain four. 1, 2, 3, 4, which counts as a double crochet and a chain one, and then continue on with mesh. I'm just going to get a couple of these out of the way. I just worked a few to get it off to the side a little bit. Now we want to take this working yarn for our triangle and work the other direction. So just flip this over, grab your loop, 3 millimeter hook, and chain one, just to get that all connected. 2 single crochets in our chain space, single crochet all the way across, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And then in this chain space we want 2 more single crochets, so we increase 2 on each side. So we increased our 11 stitches by 2 on each side, was technically 4, so we're up to 15 stitches across, which is right here. I pull up a loop, flip it back the way it was, and that working yarn, that will be our yarn that's not going to be the working yarn for just a second, because we got to finish our mesh all the way across, or all the way around, until we hook up with this again. So we'll do that one more time. So the pink, I'll put my 3 millimeter away, and I'm going to make the rest of my mesh until I'm right over here, and then we will work the next one again. And I'm almost back to my triangle, almost back to the front. So there's my last double crochet, because we are going to turn this one into a square. So we want to chain two, remember. Right before we reattach to our logo, we want to chain two. And we're going to move over to our 3 millimeter hook. Grab the loop from our triangle yarn. Whoops, make sure that that working yarn is behind it so we can actually do our single crochet. All right, that's tightened up. So we have both loops are on our hook. So we want to go through our first single crochet and bury the other yarn. And single crochet, tighten that up, single crochet through all of those. And now we want to single crochet all the way across. 2, there's number 3, 14, and 15. I'm going to take our triangle yarn and tighten it up a little bit so that our square stays square and our edges are nice and tight. Change back to our 3.5. Now we're going to chain two around the other one, chain two. In our third chain of our chain four, we want to grab the logo yarn and just pull that loop, kind of toss it off to the side. We're going to need that in just a moment. But move back to our other yarn, our mesh yarn. Go through that same chain three, the third chain, and slip stitch there, slip stitch in the chain space, and slip stitch in the next double crochet. And chain four, one, two, three, four, which counts as a double crochet and a chain one. And then we're just going to move this over a little bit. We need this yarn to be over here waiting for our mesh. So we're just going to flip this over, go back to our 3mm hook on our triangle yarn, just slip stitch and increase right here, so two single crochets in our chain space, and then we're going to single crochet all the way across, and one in every stitch, so one, two, three. There's 14 and 15, and then in this chain space we want two more single crochets because we just increased from 15 to 19. Two single crochets on this side and two on this side plus 15 in the middle. We're all the way up to 19 now. So we'll just pull that, flip it back exactly the place where it was before. And now we can work the mesh. So we're working these at the same time. So now we have our logo yarn. Our triangle yarn is waiting on the right hand side, waiting for my mesh to come back. So let's do the next one. And I'm to my last double crochet for this mesh round. So now the square. This next one is going to be hooked up with our triangle, so chain two, so we can make sure our square stays nice and square. One and two. Chained out to our 3mm, and grab the loop from your triangle yarn, tighten that all up so we get both loops on our hook, and here's our mesh yarn. And we want to bury or carry along our triangle yarn. And now let's just single crochet through all those loops. And then we'll carry this along. One single crochet in each, carrying the yarn behind. One. That's number two. 17. 18. And 19. It up a little bit, take a little tug to our logo yarn, the yarn that was carried along, make sure that's nice and tight so the square is still a square, and nice and tight so our edges are nice and tight. Swap out to our 3.5 again, and we want to chain two around our logo yarn or our triangle yarn a little bit just to get it to come along with us. Carry it along so we can work the other direction. In our third chain of our chain four, first of all, we're going to pull in our triangle yarn and just pull it through and pull a loop off to the side, off to the right just a little bit, because we'll need that in a minute. And now in that same chain three, we just want to do a slip stitch with our mesh yarn, a slip stitch in the chain space, and a slip stitch in the double crochet. Chain four, one, two, three, four. That counts as our double crochet and a chain one, just like we did on all the other ones. We move this one off to the side a little bit so we can finish our next pass on our triangle in the middle, because we always want our triangles yarn to be over here on the right hand side waiting. Gotta be waiting for the mesh to come back. So get our 3 millimeter hook again. Tighten that all up. Slip stitch, single crochet two times in that chain space. Single crochet all the way across. So we just increase by two on this side. One, two, and then there's 18 and 19. 19 in the middle, two over here, and then in this space we're going to increase two more. So there's two more single crochets. So we just increased from 19 to 23. Two on this side and two on this side, plus 19 in the middle is 23. Continue this for 10 rows, which takes your increases up to 39. So I'm not going to do all these rows on camera because that'll just make a really long video. But everything is exactly the same, increasing two on each side until you hit 39. So remember, this is 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, 23, 27, 31, 35, and 39. Alright, so I'm almost done with my very last round of connecting to my triangle. So I'm going to do my last double crochet here. And since we want to make this little square, we want to chain two. Just make sure our square stays a nice square and doesn't turn into a little rectangle. Get that loop on our hook. So we got both loops on our hook. We're going to go through the first one. Pull up. So I have three loops on my hook. And now we are going to finish our single crochet. That's the very last one. And we want to work all the way across and still carry our yarn, but we need to finish our last second pass on our 39. So here's number 2, 3, and 38. And there's number 39. We want to give the triangle yarn a little bit of a tug and make sure that it is snug so our square stays a square over here and this edge is nice. And now that we can be totally done with that yarn for right now. Now I want to chain two, just so we can keep all of these even. And in our third chain, one, two, three, yes, one, two, three. Do our slip stitch. And now we are done with our triangle. So now we're going to keep going along with chain four, one, two, three, and four, and do our double crochet. Remember, that counts as a double crochet and a chain one. So double crochet, chain one, so this one can technically, the one that was buried back here, the one that we're not using right now, can be finished off and put away. So we will be continuing on with this guy. And I'm going to work all the way around here until I get right back here and show you how this row goes. This one is just a little bit different, but not too crazy different. Because we want to start our mesh up again on top of our logo triangle. So I'll meet you back over at the start of the triangle, or the end of the triangle at this point, yay, in just a second. All right, here I am. I made it back with my mesh all the way to my triangle. We're just going to chain one like a normal mesh. And in our very first stitch from our triangle right here, I want to double crochet and chain one, skip the next stitch, double crochet. Chain one, skip the next stitch, double crochet in the stitch, chain one, skip, double crochet, chain one, skip, double crochet, chain one, skip, all the way across. Right, we made our mesh all the way across. Our very last stitch gets a double crochet and a chain one, and now we're going to do our little slip stitch into our third chain just like we had been doing all those other times. Just like that. And chain four. Okay, so now we have mesh again, just like we did down at the bottom. Our first nine rows is all mesh. Now we got a triangle in the middle. And we've got mesh right here. We wanted to do four more rounds, so a total of five. This is the first one. Four more, just like we were doing before. So our chain four is a double crochet and a chain one, double crochet, chain one, all the way around until you get back. Then you'll do your slip stitch in the third chain. Keep right on going. A total of five, so four more rows. Okay, now we're going back to my white one. So here's my five new rows. One, two, three, four, five. On top of your triangle. So find the center of your triangle and mark it right here. And then we want to have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven empty squares right here. Seven empty mesh. So then I marked these right here. So this one is in the very center. That counts as one. And then one, two, three on each side. One, two, three on each side. And mark those double crochets. And do the same thing on the opposite side. You want to mark off seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So then when you get to this end point right here, and we have our five rows done, you can finish this yarn off. We're still using our 3.5, but you can finish this one off. We're going to snip, weave in that in a little while, but you can finish this edge off, because now we have to work the tops. Because now we are finally right up here. There's our five. One, two, three, four, five. Now we're going to do these little parts right here. And the edging. Also, I marked off three on this other side. Just to give me an eyeball. Three on this side too. So what I have is there's seven here. Here, between here and here is 16. 3 here, 16, 7, 16, 3, and 16. So I have them marked off so it's really easy for me to follow along. Even if I don't want to be counting all the time, it's going to work beautifully. So the first two rows of this side are common for the two triangles. So what we're going to do is start right here fasten on our yarn, and chain two, and double crochet in the next one, not in the same one, in the next one over. So we're going to get that to go kind of at an angle. So you see how that's at an angle now. That's important. I'm going to chain one. Okay, so there's our chain two and our first double crochet and a chain one. Now we want to do our normal mesh, 32 double crochets and chain one. So there's one and two and three, and you will pass right over those other three that I have over here. They're just for me to be able to eyeball a little bit. 31 and 32. And then these last two, we're working up to these seven that I had marked off on the back side, right here. These last two, this one, and up to and including that one that I had marked, will be a double crochet two together. So we're going to yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go through the next stitch, pull through two, and then pull through all three. So that's our first common row right there. We're just building that up a tiny bit more. So we're going to do another common row. So we're going to chain two and turn our work. We're going to double crochet in the next one, not that same one, in the next one right over here. Double crochet in this one and chain one. And then do another 30 double crochets and chain ones. Another 30 of them. And 29. And there's 30 double crochet, chain one. The last two right here, boom and boom, is a double crochet two together. So we're going to yarn over, double crochet, go through two, yarn over, the next stitch, pull up the loop, go through two, and go through all three. That is the end of our common row. Now we're going to do each of these little triangles, one on each side. All right, so round three, we're going to chain two, and we're going to turn our work again. So we work on this little triangle right here. Chain two, and then not in the same one, but in the next one, we want to double crochet here and chain one, and then we want to do 10 more. Double crochet, chain one, there's nine, and here's number 10, and our chain one, and now we want a nice steep angle right here. So we're going to double crochet three together. So how we do that is yarn over, go through the first stitch, pull up a loop, go yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go through the second one, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, go through the third loop, yarn over, third loop, yarn over, pull through two, and then pull through all three. So we have all three of them here at a nice little angle. So let's do that one more time so it makes a little bit more sense. One more time. So we're going to yarn over, go through the first stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go through the third one, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through all three. So now we have our little angle. So row four, chain two, turn our work. Because now we're working back and forth in rows. So now it's double crochet two together. So the next one, Next stitch gets a yarn over, pull through two, and then for the next stitch, yarn over, pull through two, and now pull through all three. And then we are going to chain one and do 9 double crochet with a chain one mesh. There's number one, there's number 8, and number 9. And that ends row 4. Now we're doing chain 4 because we're going to start on row 5. There's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Turn our work again. And that counts as a double crochet and a chain 1. So in our next one, we're going to double crochet, chain 1. We're going to do that 7 times. There's number 2. And 7. And we're at our angled area, so we're going to double crochet 2 together, which was a yarn over, go through the next stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, go to the next stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, and then yarn over and pull through all 3. So now we have a nice little angle going right here. And that's end of round 5. Round 6 is chain 2. We're going to turn our work again because we're working in rows this time. Double crochet in the next one, chain 1, make a mesh 7 times, so double crochet and a chain 1 7 times. There's number 1, 2, and our 7th one will be in our 3rd chain of 4, just like we were doing before. So find your 3rd chain, under both of those loops, and double crochet. And so that would end row 6. Right now we'll start on row 7, which is we're going to chain 4. That counts as a double crochet and a chain 1, and turn our work again. And now we're going to double crochet 5 meshes. So there's 1 and a chain 1, 2, and 5, chain 1, and then we're going to double crochet 2 together again. So that's yarn over, go through the first stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, go through the next stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, and then pull through all 3. See, these go fast. We just ended row 7 already. Now we're row 8, chain 2. Turn our work again, double crochet in the next stitch, and chain 1, and do 5 more. Double crochet number 1, and a chain. We're going to go all the way to the end, 2, 3, 4, and number 5 is in the 3rd chain. Find our 3rd chain and do our double crochet. And that ended round 8, or row 8. Row 9 is chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn our work again, and we're going to do 3 double crochets. So the first one starts in the next stitch, 1, make chain 1, there's 2, number 2, chain 1, and number 3, chain 1, and now we want to double crochet these last 2 together. So go yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, go through the next stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, and then pull through all 3. And that's row 9. Chain 2, turn our work, and double crochet in the next, chain 1, and then do three more all the way to the end. One and a chain one, two and chain one, and the third one is in our chain number three. And that was row 10. So we're almost there. We're almost done because this is almost a triangle. Almost done. Row 11 is a chain 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn our work. Double crochet in the next. Chain 1. And then double crochet 2 together. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, go through the next stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, and then pull through all 3. So that's the end of row 11. That one was really easy, really fast. Row 12 is chain 2, turn your work again, double crochet in the next, chain 1, and double crochet in your third chain for the last stitch in this row. And that was row 12. There is one more row. Row 13 is chain 2. We're going to turn our work one more time, and now we're going to double crochet in the next, which is also the last stitch, right here. Double crochet. So there we go. There's our little triangle now. The top part of our bag. I already did this side. Sneaky. But what you can do here now is finish off this, because we have to do the other side. So we'll finish off this little triangle right here. And we are going to snippy snip, finish him off. And then we need to do the other side, just like it. So in order to get it to be exactly the same stitch counts, just flip that down and start right here at your first stitch. So we're going to fasten on our yarn again, and starting at row 3 again, because we already did 1 and 2 are the common. So this is going to be a chain 2, double crochet in the next stitch, chain 1, and then 10 more double crochet with the chain 1. There's 1, 2, and there's number 9, and number 10 with its chain 1, and then we're going to do double crochet 3 together. So that's yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over the next stitch, pull through 2, yarn over into the third stitch, pull through 2 again, and then pull through all 3. And you can see how we're doing that. To get the stitch counts and the stitches to be exactly the same, always start here and move that way. So here, I started on the outside, I was working here. This one, I started on the inside and worked that way. So that was row 3, and we're on to row 4, which is chain 2, 1, 2. Turn our work so it's exactly the same as the one that we just did. This is a double crochet 2 together. So yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, and then pull through all 3, chain 1, and now we're going to do 9 double crochets with a chain 1 in between. 1, 2, and 8. And then here's my last one, my last double crochet, that's number 9. And that was row 4. And now we're going to chain 4, which counts as a double crochet, and a chain 1. Turn our work again, and double crochet with the chain in between 7 times. 1, and 7. Chain 1 and double crochet 2 together. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, go through the next stitch, pull through two, and then pull through all three. And then row five. Again, this is exactly the same as you did before, so you can fast forward through all this if you got it down already. Row six is a chain two, turn our work. This part works up so quickly. You think you'd be very pleased when you get to this part. Double crochet in the next. Chain one and do seven more. Number six and number seven goes in our third chain from our chain four. And there we go. Now we're on to row seven. See how quickly this goes. Chain four, one, two, three, four. Turn our work, and that counts as a double crochet and a chain one. And double crochet with a chain in between five times. Whoopsie. There's a one and a chain, two, three, four, and five. Chain one, and now we're going to double crochet these last two together. Yarn over, pull through two, move to the next stitch, yarn over, pull through two, and then pull through all three. And that is the end of round seven. These last couple rows go very quickly. Chain two, turn your work. We're on row eight already. Double crochet in the next. Chain one. And do five more. One, two, three, four, and the last one will be in our third chain. And there's number five. And that was row eight. Row nine is chain four. One, two, three, four, and that counts. And we're going to do three double crochets with a chain in between each one. Whoopsie. There's one, chain two, and three, with chain one, and double crochet these last two together. So yarn over, pull through two, go to the next stitch, yarn over, pull through two, and pull through all three. There's chain two. This is row 10. Again, this is exactly the same as you did. You're going to do this four times total. Double crochet in the next. Chain one. And do that three more times. Double crochet. Chain one. Double crochet number two. And chain one, and our last one is in our third chain of our chain four. And our last double crochet right there. So you're making another little triangle. That was row 10. Row 11 is going to be chain four. One, two, three, four. Turn our work again. Double crochet in the next one right here. Chain one. And double crochet these last two together. So it's yarn over, pull through two, go on to the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, pull through two, and pull through all three. And that was row 11. Row 12 is chain two, and turn, double crochet in the next. Chain one, and then double crochet in our third chain of our chain four. And one more row. Chain two, this is row 13. Spin our work again, and double crochet in the next, which is also AKA the last stitch in this row. And there you go, there's our triangle. So now we have our sides done. One, two, and I did these ones already, three and four. Now the trick part is, and this one I did the loop that goes at the top, and those are going to connect right here. So we have to do that on this side also. So I'm going to chain 40. Chain either 40 or 50, however long you want it to be. I'm going to chain 40. 39 and 40. So now I have the part that's going to make my big handles, the arm straps, and we want to connect it to this one. Connect it to the opposite side, and this one I'm working on right now is the back. So now we're just going to attach this to the very tippy top of this side. Just do a little slip stitch. Just like that. So that one is done, so we don't want to lose that loop, so I'm just going to mark this really quick. Because I also want to do the one on the other side. Remember, I already worked half of this. So I already did my chain 40 on this one. This side I already finished off. So now we're at the front. Here's my triangle. Try to make sure it's not twisted. Get back in this loop. And then we just slip stitch to the tippy top of this triangle. And we don't want to lose that loop either. So I'm going to mark it here really quick. We have our top going on. I'm going to finish off both of these pseudo straps. They're not quite done yet. Right now they're just chains, but I'm going to finish those off. I'm going to start on the side. I like to work the outsides first before I work this oval in the middle. Since this is the front with our triangle, I'm going to start just a little bit back here, anywhere along the side. As long as it's not square in the front like this. That's what I try to do, just to make it a little bit less noticeable. And so we'll just fasten on our yarn. I'm going to fasten on right in here. So I'm fastening on in one of my double crochets. So in the double crochet, we're going to do a single crochet. And this is on the side where there's mesh, where we have the meshes. Now I want to go into that chain space and single crochet. So every time we have a mesh space, we're going to work that way. We want to do a single crochet in the double crochet on top, and then a single crochet in our chain space. And now I'm already done with that little section because I started in the center right here. So now when we're going to work up this angle, every one of these angles we want to put in two single crochets because they're two chains or a double crochet, so we want to put in two stitches so it doesn't get too tight. So right in here we want to put in two singles and then go to the next one, your next space. And the next space. This actually goes pretty quick here because there's, when we were doing all of our reducing, this got short really quick. So over to the next one, two singles. The next one, two singles. and so on until we get to our chain. And it's my last two single crochets, my last little angled piece on the top of my bag. And now we made it to the chain. Now you have two choices. You can either work in the back bumps, or you can just work like we did at the very beginning for our bottom, where we work just through one loop of the chain, because we're going to work both sides of this chain, one with the outside part and one with the little oval. So you choose whichever way you want to do it, and I'm going to just work through one loop that makes it just a little bit faster. Remember, working in those back bumps takes a little bit longer, but since we're working both sides of the chain, either way will work. So I'm just going to work one single crochet into each chain until we're to the other side. And here's my last little angle piece on the top of our strap. And now I'm down to the mesh right here. So in our mesh, we want to put one single crochet in the top of every post and one in every chain space. Across, just like this. Until you get to the other side where we have our angle again, which is right here is my last stitch. And now we're at our angles again. So we'll do the same thing we did before. Same thing we did before going up the angles is two in every gap. And here's my last gap. So this is my last two single crochets until I have made it back to the other chain on the other side. You want to do the same thing we did last time. If you worked in the back bumps, do that again. If you work through the chain, just one loop of the chain, work through one loop of the chain. Just make them look the same. So I'm going to do all one single crochet into one loop, into each loop, into each loop. Now I made it all the way back, all the way through all of those chains, and now we're going to work down the other side until we meet our very first stitch. We're almost done with the outside round. That's awesome. See how quickly this goes. So we just do like we did before. You can bury these ends as you go, but in each gap we want to put in two single crochets, and we'll get to the mesh at the bottom. One in each post, and one in our chain space till we match up with our very first stitch. All right, here's my last angle piece, my last angle stitch, two single crochets, and I'm almost back to the beginning. So one single crochet in this post, one single crochet in the chain space, and then we can finish off because we matched back up with our very first stitch. So the outside border of our straps is complete. Now we just have to do the inside and we are done. Then we can finish that off and we'll do the next piece. Okay, now we have the outside edging is all done and our strap is done on one half of the chains. And then we're going to go all the way around. Now we just have to do the two in the middle, the ovals, that do the inside. So this is really fast and easy. So we're going to fasten on our yarn again. Try to put it in a place that's not very conspicuous. Leave enough tail so that you can weave in ends in a little while. When you come to any tails along the way, try to get those to go in too. We're going to work one single crochet into the other side, the inside here of our chain, two in every chain space right here, and then down here it's the same as it was on the other side along the edge. One in the post, one in here, one in the post, one in here, one in the post, one in here. So we're just going to do that really quick. This isn't very many stitches. It goes really fast. Just fasten on here easily. and do a single crochet. And since I'm in this side part, we're going to put two in each chain space along the verticals. Two single crochets. Until we get to the bottom mesh. And there's the last one before I get to the bottom mesh, because I'm down here now. So now there's one in each post. One single crochet in a post and one single crochet in the chain space across. These seven. So there's one like that and one in the post. And one in the chain space. The top of the double crochet, chain space. Double crochet and the chain space, and one more here, and now we're only halfway. You got to finish all the way over to here, and then we're going to go up the side again. Really simple. And here's my last post, last double crochet in the front. So we get to start working up this side again. So that again, that is two single crochets in each one of these spaces until we get to the up here to the chain. Easy peasy. And here's my last space before I get back to my chains. So now we want to go down the other side. So in the other side of our chains, every one of these little spaces, you can see they're just tiny, every one of those gets one single crochet. All the way back to the other side. Now we're almost to the end of my chains. This is the last one. And now we're on the other side, and we're almost back to where we started. So just each one of these will get two single crochets until we meet up with our very first stitch. And there's my last two stitches. One and two. And then slip stitch, and you can finish this off, leave a tail long enough so that you can sew it in. Just get out a needle and sew it all in pretty. Look how beautiful that is. It's awesome. So we just weave these in, sew those in a little bit, and surprise, if we do it on the other side, I already did the other side. So now it's done, except for weaving in my ends and taking out all of my stitch markers. Isn't it gorgeous? I just love this bag. And again, if you wanted to make this a little longer, chain 50 instead of 40. I chained 40 here. Here is the one that is raffia. A little bit harder to work with, but still very fun. And then my obnoxious pink one. I'm keeping this one. I just love it. Thanks for stopping by. Thank you for supporting my small business. Please subscribe to Thimblehooks and stop back soon. I have some really fun stuff coming up. Thanks. Bye!